Hi folks, here I am, again. Not live, obviously. Thanks to an over-enthusiastic bot, or maybe two, more on that in a bit. There's been quite a few comments over the last few videos, thank you for all of them. I've read them all, and hope to address some of them in the next few minutes. But YouTube has been an important part of my life. If you look back over the nearly a decade that I've been on the platform, it's easy to see the change in my self-confidence as I've been making videos, putting them out, communicating with people, and growing as a person. It's quite a history when you look back on it. And, yep, there have been bad times as well as good, and we've pretty much got through them. And I'm immensely proud of the very small community that's grown around this channel. I've learnt possibly more from some of the people who are following this channel than people have learnt from my videos. That's how it goes. I've made lifetime friends from this channel. Shit, I better stop this before I start welling up. But yeah, to see such a thing be torn to shreds by the commercial elements has been quite disturbing. And the question is obviously, what am I going to do about it? Despite Facebook, YouTube, and others, Twitter I think also, having bitten the bullet, come to the conclusion that bots cannot save them and cannot adequately police the platforms. There's just no way that they're going to be able to hire enough human beings to take care of all this. And things like this are going to happen. Yes, I was actually following Cody's lab and did see him get hit by a second strike that was threatening to kill the channel. And the ease with which that video was taken down and a strike granted, and the speed in which the appeal was denied. A number of people now have suggested it was probably actually reviewed by a second bot rather than a human being. Given the speed that it was rejected, I think they're right. But even if they're wrong, I mean, like other people in the comments have said, there's no way that a methylated spirit burner that people can buy and buy the methylated spirit for when they're teenagers should be classified as dangerous content, for crying out loud. Life is dangerous. You can't wrap the kids in cotton wool, and you can't wrap a channel in cotton wool either. You can't wrap a service in cotton wool, which is exactly what they're trying to do. So the question is, what am I going to do about this? Well, the answer is the same that I was going to do a few years ago, but I halted because most of the people didn't follow the channels. And I've determined, then it was a slightly different thing. I came back to publishing most of the content on YouTube, and yeah, I know that people are going to fall off. I mean, I've seen that. I'm actually quite impressed at the lack of people who have unsubscribed to this channel. There have been a few who have unsubscribed to other channels, Facebook, Twitter, and I've seen them drop off. And I totally understand that. I covered that in another video. It's been quite an emotional thing, to be quite honest, and I'm doing what I can now to make sure that I complete this with some form of dignity. So what am I going to do about it? What did I attempt a few years ago? Well, four channels. Vimeo, YouTube, and two blogs. Now, I'm going to introduce you to a tool because a number of things have changed in the meantime. Specs Bean Farmer kindly gave me some of his time last night, and we've ironed out a few odds and sods and got things ready pretty much. and also something which may change your own media viewing habits. Yeah, staying on YouTube is, you can understand why people stay on one channel, you know, because, you know, keeping, monitoring a number of channels at once is not good. It's difficult and you're hopping all over the place. But there is something called RSS, Remote Syndication Service or something? Or is it RRS? RSS, I think. And there are a number of different readers, and you can subscribe to the streams. And what I'm going to show you now is the one that I'm using. There's plenty of them out there. And this is one that's on Linux. This is Lifera. There's different ones out there, and different things are going to happen. Pretty much because, well, they can happen. What am I talking about? Emotions are just clouding what I'm saying, pretty much. I've tried... I haven't taken this lightly. You know, I've tried to get in touch with YouTube. The current CEO, who put her channel up and only has two videos on it, effectively breaking the promises that she made. I left a comment there. I've left comments on Facebook, Twitter. But nobody, if you're not a big star on YouTube, nobody wants to know. Yeah, trying to get through to a human being, nobody wants to know you. And that, I think, all this together is convinced me that I need to have eggs in different baskets. We can't have all our eggs in one basket. Not only as a creator, but also as a viewer and a community, I think. Because, you know, it's like reading one newspaper for the rest of your life. You're doing yourself out of, consider me just a small columnist in a newspaper. You know, just reading the one newspaper all the time is just going to do nothing for your worldview. But reading a number of newspapers and following certain columnists is a lot more healthy. So I'm really hoping that a few of you out there will grasp this and take it further. Now, this is just one RSS reader. And on installation, this one already gives you a number of channels. This is Ars Technica. I'm not sure which the index of Ars Technica. You got slash dot there. It's an RSS feed. BBC is BBC News. On there, sciencenews.org, and you've got the feeds from there. Open source, Planet Ubuntu, they're giving you a number of feeds here, and you can follow anything. There's XKCD, the history of Unicode. I'm not actually totally getting these. Some of the early stuff was absolutely hilarious. Some of the later stuff seems to be a bit more niche. Maybe I've changed, which is possibly more often more common. Here's one for the Daily Talk Show. Come on, guys, let's get it together here. You're missing a day. yeah. Actually, I think they may just be doing weekdays. They did two on February the 5th on my time zone. Yeah, they might just be doing weekdays, I don't know. But anyway, yeah. And also Mine. Now, there are four channels in there. You've got Life of a Stranger and TechniLife. Now, those are WordPress blogs, but they're not hosted on the WordPress site. They're hosted on my hosting. So pretty much I'm having to do all the security arrangements, and all the background work in keeping them running and keeping them safe. They are comments by logon only, so that they don't get spammed. But even then, they're going to get spammed. Comments in that are... I think I've currently set them to close comments after 7 days. So when a post is made, you've obviously got to register with the service in order to be able to comment. And 7 days after making the post, comments close automatically. I think it comes from... You may... because it's on my domain, all the emails, the administration emails, comes from my domain. So because I'm not one of the big guys like the Gmails or the WordPress own mail servers or things like that, you may need to add to the whitelist in order to get the emails, because some of the other services are just junking. You know, they're a bit enthusiastic with the junk filter. So you may have to whitelist my domain, msknight.com. You'll see those in there. For me, I'm finding it freeing, because not everything can be put on the video services, to be brutally honest. Some things are better said in type, and some things are better said in Word. The other thing that's going to happen is the Life of a Stranger blog. I'm also intending to try some audio vlogs. I've got the audio equipment here to do it, obviously, but I can put on a lapel mic and walk around while I'm doing these things. Sometimes sound is more evocative than pictures. I know that's a bit, sounds a bit odd, but sometimes that is the case. A number of people I know, they like the rants, but they also don't look at the videos. While the rants are going on, they've just got them playing in the background while they're doing something else, which is fine. Nothing wrong with that at all. So I think what's going to happen is the Life of a Stranger will start hosting MP3 files of rants and things. You have the RSS feed for Vimeo, for the Vimeo channel in there as well. And also, if you go to some of them, you can see the video in the RSS feed, and you can also see all the various bits and pieces under there as well, all the links that I've put in the descriptions. You can see those all there as well, and you can play them from here, which is pretty cool. You don't actually have to leave the site. Some sites are better. Some RSS browsers are better than others. Some of them... Some of them are cross-platform, but they're more stable on some platforms than others, if you know what I mean. Be prepared to shop around for an RSS reader. There's also a problem with some websites in that, you know, one of the reasons why they do things the way they do is because they want to keep your eyes on their platform. They want to keep you restricted to their platform, and so they mess around with their RSS feeds. You will find one or two links also in the hoo-ha bar to some of the discussions that have happened on these, and some of the history. And today I intend recording an audio review of the Guardian Sunday edition. That may be out on Monday or whatever on the Life of a Stranger blog. And obviously you've got the YouTube ones here. YouTube is a bit odd in that it doesn't show you bugger all, and you have to click through to the website in order to see it. There's one attachment. Oh, hang on a minute. There's a play button down here.
The Daily Talk Show.
No, that is the Daily Talk Show. Oh, that's a nice little bug in this one. Yeah, that's the Daily Talk Show start and not this February Links News and Views. So that's one thing I'm definitely going to have to watch. Hang on a minute, what? The YouTube? Yeah, that's definitely screwed up. So that's something else to watch. But the critical thing about this is that you can see everything that's happening on multiple sources of information at the same time. You can also read the posts. New arrivals has gone in. That post was auto-released today, and that gives you some new arrivals that came in. Again, I didn't actually have to make a video about them. I could just take some pictures and slam them up for people to have a look at. The history on some of these blogs goes back 2006, some of them. And even me, looking back at some of those posts, is a bit scary to look back at how I was thinking and some of the stuff that's happened to me. Yeah. But it's there for you. In the hoo-ha bar, you will find the links. You'll also find the links for some of the channels with both the RSS2 and the... what was the other feed name? Alexa? No, not Alexa. Atlas. Duh. You might want to do a review into the difference between RSS2 and Atlas and work out which feed you think is going to be better for you. But this kind of thing can definitely open up a lot of different platform sources for you. So there you actually have a way to keep track of me all throughout the different platforms. How's that? Yeah. There actually has been another addition today, and that is Rondo Veneziano Masterpieces. That's also dropped through. That's quite nice. The one thing I can obviously do on, because the websites are run by me, is I've got a little bit more flexibility. You know, I haven't got to worry too much about the matching. And also, if one of the channels goes down, if YouTube does decide to go totally bonkers, as it did with a number of other people, I honestly thought that you know, Cody's Lab had enough of a following to carry some clout, you know? Apparently not. Yeah. So posting like this, I can do without having to set up the cameras, because some things get a bit bonkers around here, to put it mildly. And I've wanted to make more use of this mic. I still want to do more. One of the things I'm going to bring is this weekend, bonkers. Next weekend, bonkers. The weekend after, I might have some time to give you guys a look at. Look at the voice bank, donating voice, and see what it looks like, so you can get a feel for it. And I'll be able to use some of these other microphones without fear of them getting in the way of the camera, you know. Sorry. So what's going to be on what channel? What can you expect? Well, Vimeo doesn't do games. So the games content will still be here. I realise that although the Steve Crusoe has got a very small audience, it's a dedicated one. And I've been doing that for about 1.5 years or nearly 2 years. I've lost track. So I'm going to, when time permits, I'm going to keep doing that series. And I'm going to keep posting them here. What can I say pretty much on that one? I've also wanted to do more of the 5 credits of series and post them as well. That way, if I lose them, if I lose the channel, I'm not losing too much. I might do some of the odds and sods videos here. And I don't know. Basically, this YouTube channel is now basically throwaway. My voice is going. That's pretty much what this has now become. The Vimeo channel already has a chunk of the major stuff on it. It already has most of the... it has the Checkmate series on it. Nothing more is going to be added. I can't see me adding anything more to that unless society does a major change. So I think that's pretty much complete. The audio files, which I thought was complete, is not, now that cassette has come across. And that's going to be added too. You've got the ZFS stuff on that channel as well. Basically, I want to try and leave the Vimeo channel to the major stuff that's actually going to benefit people, as opposed to me just yakking on at the camera. So, yeah. Next month, when I get another paycheck, I will be paying for more membership, and I'll be talking with them about about the tip jar. What can I say? Pretty much. There's not much to say. Well, the Technolife blog will contain the technical posts, like the IT news and views that I want to comment on. Also, some of the equipment side of things, like the Xbox progress, that will be on there. If it's not on a video, it'll be on there. I mean, to be honest, some of the stuff, it's easier to take pictures as I go, because sometimes I just need to slow up, and the cameras just can't handle it in terms of power. You know, I've got to do as much as I can in the time limit that the cameras have got before I then have to turn things off, charge batteries, and then everything comes to a halt. And there are things that are backlogged here, you know. One of the videos that I definitely want to do on the technical side is the case, the new home for Shady. Yeah. I don't think that some of the stuff like the Xbox is going to be too groundbreaking. And certainly I want to do at least one of them before, you know, without the pressure, the added pressure of filming. Because it is delicate work. They are small solder joints. And there was one video that I've watched that I've linked somewhere else, and I'll continue to link it in those videos that I do on that. And he was basically said, look, you need flux. And if someone's saying you need flux, then stuff's heat sensitive. So I've got to be careful of what I'm doing. And yeah, but at least when I'm doing that sort of thing, I can take pictures and I can write them up, which is which actually gives you guys more material, believe it or not. There's another piece of equipment that you can probably see over my shoulder here. There, which is a Sony Hi-Fi. I haven't vlogged about that. Pretty much it's coming in and going out. And I haven't gone into any of the detail about a lot of the other equipment here. Because pretty much video isn't exactly the best medium for that. And, you know, different mediums have different strengths and different weaknesses. So by using more medium, I give you guys more content that matters, for want of a better way of putting it. Yeah. So that's pretty much how things are going to go down. Obviously, I'm going to be reading all the comments, watching the kind of things that happen. I know some people are not going to like using RSS feeds, but some people are going to stick to the YouTube channel, and that's fair enough. I totally understand, totally get it. But look into RSS feeds. I mean, not only just for keeping track of me and my few bits and pieces, but also other channels. And it might be worth, given how things are going, I really think that other channels should be doing this as well. I mean, if Cody's Lab just had a WordPress blog and was just publishing things to there, because, you know, doing the filming and the editing of things can be a lot more complicated. And if people have got hooked into an RSS feed, then if something happens to the YouTube, Cody's got a way of getting things out. Because one of the things that happens is that YouTube is definitely aware of backup channels, of people having backup channels. And the trick is, there are links between those channels. certainly I know it. I run a couple of channels myself. There's the Your Linux Life, which will now be on Vimeo when I get round to it. When I get that off the table. and yeah. I'm going to need some other music. I might actually contact Brian, because I for the music side of things and the equipment, the testing tape is YouTube Music, because that was intending to go up on YouTube. But now I'll have to make another tape. I've wasted a J card, sodded. Full of YouTube music to use as tests, so I can sling a YouTube tape in and play it to test equipment and not have to worry about blatting music out of things. There's been a couple of other things. I got these, which are ammo pouches. And because a lot of the Walkmans these days, you can't get the cases. That's Velcro, so I'll rip it away from the microphone. But there's a Sony Walkman there. I've decided, that because the 303s are taking a bit of time, I decided to get another couple of Walkman. And this is another Iowa. This is the PX557. Not up to the standard. The 557 is not up to the standard of the 303s, to put it mildly. It's not even up to the standard of the P505 that I've been listening to. But it, nevertheless, I wanted to have some other Walkman around that I could listen to while others were being taken apart. This Sony is not really worth it. It's run by one AA, and it's the WMEX502. I don't think that the single AA is powerful enough to run it as it needs to be run. But certainly in these pouches, which can also take a couple of AA tapes, you know, and a spare set of batteries. Bonus. Because you can't get the proper holders anymore. I'm doing more on that as it happens, but yeah. So pretty much now you know what's going to happen and how things are going to happen. The blog posts are already starting, as you can see, with a couple from the last few days. I also joined a credit union with my employer. Has the ability to send a deposit straight from my wages. So I've set up a small deposit in the first instance, and we'll see what happens. Increase it as I go. Because certainly, over the next couple of months, I think I'll have all the bits and pieces that I want, or all the major bits and pieces that I want. I want to finish the Pink Floyd record collection. There's another six there. There's a couple of Blu-rays that I want to get. There's a few things outstanding here and there that I'm still waiting to come through the post, but those are pretty much already paid for, except for one or two. I got one person who sort of goes quiet whenever I mention getting them money. And, yeah, you know who you are. So the long story short, I believe that the way things are going is that you need a channel which is not on YouTube. Because they do have the capability of slamming all your backup channels. They know who you are. They've got the links. Because even if you sign out, you'll see that when you go in to sign in again, it's got a link of all the accounts that browser has seen. And yeah, then they're linked. They can do what they like. Things are just getting a bit hairy. So I'm going to cut this off, guys. And do a few bits and pieces, and then I want to sit down with a microphone and record going through this Sunday edition of The Guardian, which I'm not thinking is going to be very much, because a chunk of it that's in it I already know about. I might take the odd picture while I'm doing it, just to add it to the audio post. So take care of yourselves, and I'll see you where I see you. Obviously, you don't need to register an account on any of the blogs unless you actually want to comment. Whether you want to actually go and grab your grab your moniker, screen name, or whatever is up to you. The email system is confirmed working, so if you don't get an email with your password in 10 minutes, 30 minutes, then you probably want to add the domain to your junk filters, because I can confirm that it is working. I'm not keeping any statistics on the WordPress blogs. The one problem with the WordPress blogs are the plugins. Some of them, I was running them a few years ago, and they got hacked pretty much. Well, I don't know if they got hacked, but a load of blog entries just vanished one day. Poof. Whoops. Hit the microphone. And I don't know why. There does seem to be a lot of talk on the internet, and has been for years, about blog posts just sudden, blogs just losing all their posts all of a sudden. And so I was lucky I had a backup, but it was a few months old. And I don't know whether it was some of the plugins themselves having bugs that were doing this sort of thing, or whether people were actually managing to get into the WordPress blogs and delete blogs on when there were posts that they didn't like. And as it happens, the blog that was affected was the blog which had had some contentious posts recently at that time. So I've got my suspicions, but I've got no proof. So anyway, folks, I'll catch you whenever I catch you. Take care of yourselves. See you later. And if you are a creator, you might want to think about doing something like this yourself, just because of the way things are, but also because different mediums allow you different ways of putting things out there. Bye for now.